Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. I am Lewis. One of the solution design factors on AWS is service quotas. Service quotas, also referred to as service limits, are the maximum number of resources that you can create in an AWS account. AWS implements quotas to provide highly available and reliable service to you and protect you from unintentional spend. Each quota starts with an AWS default value. Based on your needs, you can request to increase quota values for your specific account. I have experienced the disruptions to my applications when my resource usage reached the limit of AWS service quotas. Today, we will discuss a solution pattern that will allow you to proactively track your application resource usage and send notifications to you when the usage approaches to AWS service quotas. With this solution, you will be able to avoid the disruptions to your applications. Let's dive in. To monitor your application resource usage on AWS, you can use AWS Trusted Advisor and AWS service quotas. AWS Trusted Advisor will notify you once you reach more than 80% of a service quota. You can then follow recommendations to delete resources or request a quota increase. To proactively track resource usage without having to jump onto console or run CLIs manually, you can deploy an AWS Lambda function to run once every 24 hours. The Lambda function refreshes the AWS Trusted Advisor service limits checks to retrieve the most current utilization and quota data through API calls. Trusted Advisor calculates usage against the quota to determine the service utilization status. With AWS service quotas, you can view and manage your quotas for AWS services from a central location. As part of this automation workflow, you can deploy a second AWS Lambda function to check AWS service quotas and retrieve vCPU usage and quota data for every AWS region. The function runs every 5 minutes and calculates vCPU usage against the quotas to determine vCPU utilization status. Amazon CloudWatch Events captures the status events from Trusted Advisor and the vCPU monitoring Lambda function, and uses a set of CloudWatch Events rules to send the status events to all your selected targets. You may use Slack or other messaging tool for your day-to-day work. You can activate Slack notifications by deploying an AWS Lambda function that sends notifications to your existing Slack channel. An AWS System Manager parameter store is also deployed to provide highly available, secure, durable storage for your Slack webhook URL, which is used to send messages to the Slack channel. Amazon SQS receives all the OK, warn, and error status. The limit summarizer Lambda function ingests the messages from the queue and stores them onto Amazon DynamoDB table for historical view of all quota-related events in your accounts. The dead letter queue stores all messages that couldn't be read by the limit summarizer function. If your applications are deployed to multiple AWS accounts, you can deploy an AWS Lambda function that refreshes the Trusted Advisor service limits checks in a secondary account, and deploy an AWS Lambda function to check service quotas for vCPU quotas. CloudWatch Events in a secondary account captures the status events from both functions and sends those events to the primary account using CloudWatch Event Bus. Once those events are received in the primary account, the CloudWatch Events rules send the events to your chosen targets. In this episode, we discussed a solution that helps you to proactively track your application service usage that prevents unexpectedly reaching AWS service quotas. Please check out the links in the details below. See you next time.